Comparing SD-WAN models, self-management versus managed service provider. As mentioned above, no one model is better than another. We can find advantages both if the company decides to manage its SD-WAN using its own resources, and if it prefers to outsource this responsibility to a managed service provider. Self-management, DIY. Some advantages of the self-management or DIY option include control. When a company manages its own SD-WAN, it has more control over how the network is implemented and managed. This means it can adapt the network to meet its own specific needs, thereby improving network performance and efficiency. Increased internal technical knowledge. A company with a highly trained and experienced IT team would be more likely to want to manage its own SD-WAN network rather than having to depend on a third party. This way, the company has greater control over the network and can quickly and efficiently resolve any technical issues that may arise. Lower cost in the long run. Companies can save money long-term by managing their own SD-WAN network, since they won't have to face the extra costs of a service provider. Managed service provider model. Here are some advantages for the company if it decides to outsource the management of its SD-WAN to a managed service provider. Expertise. Choosing a managed service provider with extensive experience in deploying and operating SD-WANs can lead to improved network performance, efficiency, and security. Cost savings. Outsourcing the task of managing SD-WANs to a reputable third party could prove more cost-effective than hiring or training an in-house IT team to take on this responsibility. Save time and resources. The service provider can take care of provisioning, configuring, supervising, and maintaining the SD-WAN network, ensuring it is kept up to date, secure, and running optimally. This can help the company to focus on its main objectives by relieving time and resources.